Namaste student, how are you all? Hope you are doing good. I think you can able to find me. Yes, I'm your English teacher. Everyone are enjoying your quarantine, I know that. But you should not be out of the classroom. So today I'm going to take you inside the classroom. Think that you are in SVM school. So we are going to have a nice fun with the grammar class. Before moving into the topic, I have a question for you. Ready for the question? Yes. Can a human survive without a heart? Any answers? Yes, exactly. The answer is correct. Without heart, a person cannot survive. Your answer is correct. But in recent days, this is for your knowledge, but in recent day, a 37-year-old man survived for 6 months without heart and pulse. Do you know how it is? Only using a mechanical equipment. It happened in Czech Republic country. Yes, he survived for 6 months. So this is for your knowledge. So a person cannot survive without a heart. In the same way, because heart is a part of a human body. In the same way, if you want to speak, we have a certain parts for our speech. So today we are going to see 8 parts of speech. Already we have seen this. Again, we are just recollecting all the grammar things. Okay. So we are having totally 8 parts of speech. So first one is noun. Okay. Second one, it is going to be pronoun. Okay. Second one is pronoun. So next, third one is verb. Fourth one is adverb. Fifth one is adjective. Sixth one is preposition. Seventh one is conjunction. Eighth one, interjection. Okay, so this 8 parts plays a major role for constructing a speech. It's more like a basement, which is very important for a building. Only this 8 thing, we have other things also, but this 8 basic is going to be a basement for speech building. Okay, so in this 8, today we are going to concentrate on the topic noun. Okay, we'll continue on the topic noun. Now we are going to continue with the topic noun. Okay, so what is mean by noun? Noun is a naming word of a person, place, animal and thing. Okay, we have a certain examples here. The first example is Ramu. Ramu is a name of a person. We'll be addressing a person as a Ramu. Okay, then next is Delhi. It is a name for a place. Next one is elephant. It is a name for an animal. Next, Reena is again a name of a person. And book, we will address the things. Okay, we'll give a name for a things. So book comes under the category of thing. Okay, so these are the examples which are known as noun. Okay, now we are moving on to the next topic, kinds of noun. Okay, kinds of noun. How many kinds of nouns are there? Already we seen this topic. How many kinds of nouns are there? Yes, exactly. 5 kinds of nouns are there. So we are going to take a quick look about all that 5. Okay, the first one is proper noun. First one is proper noun. Second one is common noun. Third one is collective noun. Fourth one, abstract noun. And fifth one is material noun. You know how many kinds of noun? So now we are going to see kinds of noun. In that, first one is proper noun. Okay, what is mean by proper noun? Proper noun is nothing but you will be talking about a person, place or a thing in a specific manner or in a particular manner. Okay, so for that only we'll use proper noun. Okay, for a small, I will narrate you a small incident. Imagine that 3 person are walking on the road. Okay, I'm calling, hey. What they will do? All the 3 will be turning and looking at me. If I say, hey Ramu, what Ramu will do? Only Ramu will be turning and looking at me. All the two will be walking forward. So there I am particularly pointing out Ramu. So Ramu there is a particular noun. Okay, I have listed some examples here. See, New Delhi. If I am particularly talking about New Delhi. Again, Naina, India, Ganges, Bhagavad Gita. all this are a particular thing where I am specifically concentrating on each and individual thing. So all this known as a proper noun. Next, we are moving on to common noun. Common noun is nothing but we'll be addressing an individuals into a one particular genre. So that is known as a common noun, where Raju, Ramu, Somu, all our boys, okay? I can put all them into one category where they will be considered as men, okay? I cannot tell Raju, Somu and Ramu as a each individual men. No, not at all. I am putting all that into a one category. So we have certain example. Boy in the sense, it including all the boys in the world, not a individual, okay? Then same will for the girl also. Cities, if it is a cities, I can tell Bangalore city, Delhi city, that becomes a proper noun because I am particularly telling Bangalore, Chennai, okay? City in the sense, all Bangalore, Chennai, all cities will come under this. So this is considered as a common noun. Next, school. Take school in the sense, Dharmapuri districts have a lot of school, okay? So we are considering all, we are putting all school in one category, school. If we are going to talk about SVM school, that becomes a proper noun. So we are going to look the difference between the proper noun and common noun. Okay. So the comparison between the proper noun and common noun is going to be very easy. See, if I am particularly talking about the person who is watching this video, you are going to be the proper noun. If I am going to talk about the all the student committee who are watching this video, they are going to be a common noun. So this is the difference between the proper noun and common noun. Clear with this? Okay. Next, we are moving to the other example. Here I have listed person, place and things. Okay. I never mentioned what is proper and common noun. Okay. Now you people are going to give me what is proper and common noun. Yes, your answer is great. Okay, now I am going to explain. You check whether your answer is correct or wrong. Okay, I have given, you have to note a point in this where I have given the name of a person, place and thing, and I have given all the initial letter in capital. Why? Okay, yes, your guessing is correct because the proper noun always take a capital letter because it is the rule in English grammar. So all the proper noun will take a capital letter. Okay. Then in common noun, it is more like a not a capital letter because we will continue with the common sentence. Okay. Here child is a common noun where particularly I am talking about Chand. Chand is a character or a person name. Next, I am talking about a city. City in the sense in general. If I am talking about a Chennai city, I am specifically pointing out a city, Chennai. Next, cold drinks. We have a lot of cold drinks brands, okay? But here I am talking about only Coca-Cola, okay? So this is the difference between the proper and common noun. Is that clear to everyone? Okay, next we are going to see what is meant by collective noun. Okay, collective noun is nothing but consider you have a lot of stick in your house. Okay, can you lay all that stick inside the house? No. What you will do, you will collect all the stick and you will bundle it. So where you will collect everything and put into a one thing. Okay, so that is known as collective noun. We have a certain words for collective noun which refers. Here I have listed certain words which refers for only people. All these words we use only for people. Okay, board. If we are using this board in the sense, board of committee, board of people, board of headmasters. Okay, we can tell. Next one, choir. Choir in the sense, choir of singers, choir of musician. Okay, then class. Class of students. Next, committee of judges. Family of members, family of students, all that we can give for people alone. Next is for animals. What are the words? Flock, herd, swarm. Flock in the sense, flock of sheep. Next one, herd of cattle. Next, swarm of bees. Okay, all these words can be given only for animals. Next, for things we have certain words, bunch, bundle, fleet, pack and deck. So if we want to use this word bunch in the sense, we cannot tell bunch of people, okay? Because this bunch only refers to thing. So we can give it as bunch of flour. Next one, bundle of stick. Next, fleet of sheep. Next, pack of card. Deck of cards, okay? So all this are collective noun, okay? Next, we are going to listen what is meant by abstract noun.
Okay,
abstract noun is a thing where you cannot let people to show because it's unseen thing. Only you can feel it. You cannot see it because it's not like an object or nothing. Okay, it's more like an inner feeling. For example, if you have a wound on your hand, okay, that wound can be seen by others, but the feelings can sense only by you. So that is known as abstract noun. We have a certain words here. Peace. What is mean by peace? You will have that calmness in you. Okay, that is peace. That cannot be shown or able to see by our eyes. Only we can feel it. Okay, so peace, hope, honesty, faith, wisdom, idea, all these things can be sensed, but we cannot show it to others because it's more like an inner feeling. So clear with abstract noun. Next, we are moving to material noun. Okay, material noun is nothing but the thing which can use to create another thing. That is known as material noun. For example, we have gold. That is one of the mineral where it can be used for doing a stead, okay, doing anklet, all the things we can make out of gold. So I have listed some examples for material noun: ink, clay, wood, gold. Okay, ink, clay, wood, gold. Okay, using clay, what can we do? We can do pot. Okay, we can do a doll and lot of things we can do. Okay, I think you people are doing at this quarantine time. Okay, next, using wood, what can we do? Yes, you are correct. We can do furnitures. Okay, next, I told already explained about the goal. So we have seen parts of speech. In that, how many parts of speech we have seen? 8. Very good. In that particularly, I taught you noun. How many kinds of nouns are there? Yes, very good. We have 5 kinds of noun. Okay, already we are just going to have a quick recap about it. Okay, first one is proper noun, common noun, collective noun, abstract noun, and material noun. Hope you enjoyed this class. Just recollect all the things, all the content what I teach you, and don't forget to do your worksheets. Okay, so I will catch you on the next class. Hope you will do well, stay safe, and stay at home, don't trouble your parents. Okay, thank you.